Thank you very much for inviting me. It's a great pleasure for me to present this paper, which is co-written with Emmanuel Flacher, Gilles Hachem, and Sébastien Laurent. So in this paper, we focus on predicting housing prices. And to do so, we propose a new class of models that combines econometrics and machine learning. So as you know, in recent years, we have witnessed the emergence of machine learning methods, which are techniques that are based on smart algorithms that are learning by themselves. And as you also probably know, these techniques became really popular nowadays. And more precisely, they even became the standard approach for building predictive models. Indeed, many recent studies highlighted that machine learning algorithms, such as the random forest or the XGBoost, are more effective than traditional econometric approaches to model complex relationships. Why? Simply because these algorithms can automatically capture many complex non-linear relationships through non-parametric approaches, resulting in higher predictive performances. However, despite these predictive advantages, these algorithms still raise a very important issue for the industry due to their lack of interpretability. Indeed, most of these algorithms are generally considered to be black boxes whose decision process is not interpretable. Indeed, usually with an econometric model, we can determine whether the effect of a variable is significant or not. If it's the case, we can determine if the effect is positive, negative, etc. We can compute the marginal effects, etc. And all these type of informations allow in the end to interpret the results of the model. But the thing is that it's not possible to answer to these questions using machine learning algorithms. And this is for the moment the main weakness of these algorithms, which still limits their use in the industry despite their accuracy. So to address this issue, some approaches have been developed in the literature, and in particular, some model-agnostic methods have been recently proposed to interpret ex-post predictions of black box models, examples being the accumulated local effect, the LIME, or the SHAP. But in contrast to these approaches, we rather propose in this paper a class of models which are inherently interpretable and which is denoted as gamma, which include two main models, the model GAMLASSO and the model GAMAutometrics. The idea of our approach is that instead of explaining the predictions of black boxes, we rather design models that are fundamentally interpretable, just like traditional econometric models. But unlike traditional econometric models, ours are expected to compete with machine learning algorithms in terms of predictive performance. And to do so, we combine the predictive performance of machine learning algorithms that come from their ability to capture complex nonlinear relationships and interaction effects to the inherent interpretability of econometric models that allows to explain the effect of variables. So to illustrate the advantages of our new models, we focus in the paper on the predictions of housing prices. So this is our dataset. We have a bit more than 500 observations for 13 exploratory variables, two of which being qualitative. And to evaluate the predictive performance of the different models considered, we rely on the tenfold cross-validation approach, which is based on the mean squared error. So generally speaking, in this context of predictions, machine learning algorithms, which are the benchmark approach of the literature currently, can be defined like this, where f here is a non-parametric function. So in fact, the high predictive performances of machine learning algorithms come from these non-parametric functions that allow to automatically and accurately capture complex non-linear effects of covariates as well as interaction effects. And to do so, these non-parametric functions rely almost exclusively on data. So this is really the main advantage of these algorithms. These non-parametric functions can capture these two types of effects, the non-linear effects of covariates, as well as the interaction effects. And to do so, they do not require to specify a particular relationship between X and Y. So this is the main advantage of machine learning algorithms. And among the many algorithms that have been proposed in the literature, ensemble methods such as the random forest and the XGBoost have been shown to lead to very accurate predictions recently. More precisely, these two algorithms are considered as the benchmark models of the literature. Their results are considered as the best that one can obtain for the moment. So here is, for example, the definition of a random forest. So it's an aggregation of several bootstrapped decision trees where B here corresponds to number of trees of the forest, and this is the definition of the decision tree algorithm. So here, the predictive performance of this algorithm comes from disaggregation of bootstrap decision trees that allows in the end to capture complex relationships. So we applied this our model in our application, as it is one of the two benchmarks of the literature. And this is the result that we obtained, a mean squared error, which is close to 10. So 10 is approximately the best result that we can obtain on our data set. The thing is that this performance comes at the cost of the interpretability of the algorithm, which is a black box. Indeed, from this algorithm, we cannot deduce any information regarding the effect of explanatory variables. The only information that we can get is the following figure, that reports the importance of variables in the algorithm. So here, what we can deduce is that these two variables are by far the most important in the application, but that's all. Apart from that, we cannot deduce information, any information regarding the sign of the effect of these variables, whether the effect of these variables are significant or not. We cannot deduce any information regarding their marginal effects, etc., etc. So from the viewpoint of an economist, this is not enough to interpret the results of the algorithms. So this is what we obtain for the random forest, and we obtain similar results for the second benchmark of the literature, the XGBoost, a mean squared error which is also close to 10, but once again, the results are not interpretable because the algorithm is too complex, and this complexity contrasts with that of the traditional econometric approach that consists in a simple OLS regression, just like this one. As you know, it's a really simple model that assumes a linear relationship between X and Y, and thus the model is easily interpretable. We can determine whether the effect of a variable is significant or not. We can determine the sign of its effect. We can compute marginal effects, etc. But at the same time, the simplicity of this model is also its main weakness because it only captures linear effects. And thus, it leads to lackluster performance compared to previous machine learning algorithms in the presence of complex relationships. And this is obviously what we obtain in our application. Here, we obtain a mean squared error which is close to 24, which is much larger than those that we obtained for previous machine learning algorithms, but the result is completely understandable because this model does not capture nonlinear effects nor interaction effects. So, a common approach to solve this issue of the standard parametric model is to augment the previous model with parametric functions of x in order to capture potential nonlinearities through parametric transformations of explanatory variables. Typical examples being the quadratic and the cubic functions, as well as the interactions between covariates, as it is written here. So we apply this kind of approach in our application. And these are the results that we obtain for these augmented parametric models. But once again, here the performances are still not convincing because the mean squared error are much larger than those obtained for these machine learning algorithms. So here we can deduce that first, parametric transformations fail to accurately capture the nonlinear effects of covariates. And here, at this point, we can clearly observe the main difference between the two types of approach of the literature. We either have high-performing black box models or interpretable models, but with limited predictive power. So at this point, the question is it possible to bring together the main advantage of each type of model, the accuracy of machine learning algorithms, and the inherent interpretability of econometric models? And we propose in the paper a solution to this question with our GAMLA approach that I'm going to present you right now. So we just saw that while the parametric functions may fail to accurately capture the nonlinear effects of covariates, on the other side, the accuracy of machine learning algorithms comes from the non-parametric functions that allow to automatically and accurately capture these nonlinearities. So in the paper, we propose to use this type of nonlinear function but in an econometric model, in order to keep the model easily interpretable. And one approach that allows to do so is the generalized additive model, denoted as GAM. Indeed, this model allows to relax the assumption of linear relationship between X and Y and automatically captures nonlinear effects, just like this, where GJ here is the smooth function. So here, these smooth functions are in fact unspecified function of x. They are non-parametric functions that allow flexible specifications of the dependence of y on x, exactly like machine learning algorithms. So we applied this approach in our application, and this is the result that we obtain. Here we can see that the result of this GAM is better than those of the augmented parametric models, because here the GAM accurately captures the non-linearities thanks to the smooth functions. But still, we can see that there are some differences between the GAM and these machine learning algorithms. Here, this difference, the 3 points of difference here, come from the interaction effects that are missing in the GAM. Indeed, the smooth functions of the GAM do not capture the interaction effects, unlike the nonlinear functions used in these machine learning algorithms. So this is why, in the paper, we propose to use the following class of partial linear models, which are based on a GAM here, augmented by interaction effects, denoted here as Z, and where gamma is the associated set of parameters. So here, this class of model thus allows to accurately capture both non-linearities of covariates, thanks to these smooth functions, as we saw previously, but also the interaction effects. So here, models that are following this representation can accurately capture many complex relationships, similarly to machine learning algorithms. However, note that here, this approach can potentially involve a large number of interaction effects to estimate, and thus there is a risk of overfitting. So to solve this issue, we propose to proceed to interaction selection, and to do so, we rely on the methods of Lasso and Automatrix. However, the selection cannot be applied in standard way. Indeed, here we use partial linear models, and in this case, potential bias in the estimation of nonlinear terms can potentially disturb the estimation of the linear parametric coefficients, so the coefficients of interaction effects, which can lead to an inconsistent selection of these interactions. So to solve these issues, we propose in the paper to combine variable selection methods, so Lasso and Automatrix, with the double residual methodology of Robinson. So I'm skipping the technical details because I don't have the time to present them, but just to give you the intuition, the double residual methodology allows to filter the effect of the smooth functions on the linear terms estimate, so that we can consistently estimate these linear terms coefficients and obtain a consistent selection of interactions. And we illustrate this part in the paper. So we applied these new models in our application. Once we have selected these interaction effects, the smooth functions and the parameters of the selected interactions are estimated from the following GAM model, where Z star here is the set of interactions selected by Lasso or Automatrix. And we denote as Lasso the resulting model from a Lasso selection, and as GAM Automatrix the model obtained with Automatrix. So we applied these models in our application, and here are the results for different values of the tuning parameters of the Lasso and Automatrix. So here we can see that the performances of these models are better than those of the GAM, because here these models take into account the interaction effects. And we can also see that the performances of these models are similar to those of the state-of-the-art machine learning algorithms of the literature. So here we can see that our new models can compete with these state-of-the-art algorithms in terms of predictive performance. But the main advantage of our models is that they remain interpretable, unlike these algorithms. Indeed, the smooth function of our models can be graphically represented, which allows us to determine what are the effects of each feature, is the effect linear or not. If the effect is non-linear, we can also observe the shape of the non-linearity. So for example, we can determine whether the effect is quadratic or cubic, for example. We can determine when the effect is positive, negative, etc., which is impossible to determine from machine learning algorithms, as we saw previously with the example of the random forest. Moreover, we can also interpret easily the interaction effects, and we can also compute the marginal effects similarly as traditional econometric models. So briefly, to show you some results on the interpretability, Here are some smooth functions for one of our model in our application. So quickly here, just to show you, we can see that the effect of this variable seems to be linear, or at least it is very close to be linear, or that the effect of this variable here is non-linear, and more precisely, we have a quadratic effect. In fact, these two variables were those that were by far the most important in the random forest, in the figure that I showed you previously. But the thing is that with the random forest, we had no idea on what were the impact of these two variables. Here, with our new approach, we can determine what are the effects of these variables. So here we can see that the effect of this one is almost linear, and here we have a quadratic effect. So I'm almost out of time. So briefly, before concluding, we can also, with our approach, easily compute marginal effects. So here, this is the marginal effect of this variable. Here, the marginal effect is obviously non-linear because the effect of the variable is non-linear. So there are additional things in the paper, but I'm already out of time. So briefly to conclude, we propose in the paper a new class of models that allow to predict accurately the housing prices, as well as interpreting the relationships that have been captured, which allows in the end to avoid the traditional trade-off between the performance and the interpretability. Thank you very much for your attention.